It's Gwyneth Herbert! Hello, Buckner!
Well, I don't know about you, but I'm having a lovely time. Are you having a lovely time? Yes. Say it one more time for the fabulous David Devon and his spirit wife. We have all been to Pimlico, and it did have a lovely gallery. So I am Gwyn, and this is Ned, indeed. And we're going to play some songs from the last six albums. This first one is about a very particular walk, which is the walk from the 277 night bus stop in Hackney back to my old flat on Mare Street. And when I was on kind of coming back from gigs in central London, I used to take my ukulele out and play concerts to and with, share songs with some of the people sleeping on the streets on the route home. One of whom was called Dave, and Dave used to sleep outside the Texaco garage on Mare Street. And in his left-hand pocket, he kept a load of Star Wars figurines. And in his right-hand pocket, he kept a load of Star Trek figurines. And he never mixed the two. But he actually spoke fluent Klingon, which is an incredible, if not very transferable, skill. So this song will feature Dave and some of the beautiful sights of East London, including Lidl, because we are looking for sponsorship. This song is called So Worn Out. Am I faking shit? Falling off the 277, chippies up in little bites of heaven, and I'm so worn out. The knife throws out a diamond rug, and take your hand, one yellow stripy glove, and you're so worn out. Young girl fumbles for a cigarette, looking for a spark, hasn't found it yet, and she's so worn out. Star Trek man with his figurines, that's Dave, Cox and Klingon. They know just what it means, that he's all worn out. Hang on, take her on the run, we'll stumble to the moon and back to the moon. Hang on, let me bite you through the door. You are the droid I'm looking for, looking for. Dolphins cooking up a storm, bouncer below is to keep his fingers warm, and he's so worn out. Yellow tape and neon skies, little shouts about its special lover pies, but they're all sold out because they're spectacularly good value and really very tasty. Hand the one to me, dick up on the run, we'll stumble to the moon and back to the moon. I'm looking for, looking for. Oh. Thank you.
Amazing.
Thanks. The rocks below, the lightning above, clouds making raindrops while we made love in the sea. Everything was so much sweeter when you shared it all with me. Your lips, the salt in your kiss, your sun-drunk tears reflecting the misty blue. Everything was so much sweeter when I shared it all with you. My best thing, you made the world sing. I remember the tune. Blue, your pair of eyes, you candied the skies, you sugared the moon. The starshot night, your hand in my back, heads full of light and mouthfuls of daiquiri, strawberry. Everything was so much sweeter and you shared it all with me. Two sticks, two names in the sand, while Leonard crooned and Woody Suzanne. And ooh, everything was so much sweeter when I shared it all with you. My best thing, you made the world sing. I remember the tune and your pear-drop eyes, you candied the skies, you sugared the moon. I'll not leave you with nothing, no, you gave me it all those boxes of memory in the hall. The salt of all that song was from my sixth album called The Sea Cabinet, and I live just around the coast. In fact, we live in Hastings.
Hastings!
And I love living by the sea, and my sixth album is all inspired by stories of the British coastline. This next one was inspired to me by a story told to me by my Welsh Grandma Muriel. Grandma Muriel always presented every historical story like it was complete fact. She was there, man. She's like a primary historical source for the eternity of the world. So, during the Napoleonic Wars, all of the Welsh coastline was unprotected because the British redcoats were off fighting Napoleon and his army elsewhere. So the big cheeses, or the Grand Fromage back in Cameray, decided to send a fleet of recently released vagabonds and criminals to invade the Welsh coastline. And there was a young cobbler's wife called Jemima Fowler who was picking cockles on the beach with exactly 49 of her friends. My grandma Muriel was very specific on this fact. And she saw the fleet, so she gathered together her pals, and they all stood lining the Welsh Fish Guard white cliff tops, all dressed in traditional Welsh costumes, so with like black and white tunics and chimney pot hats and scarlet petticoats and knickers. And the count of three, as the ships came closer, they all flashed their scarlet pants to the sea below. And the ships, just seeing lines of black, red, white and black, thought there were literally thousands of British troops lining the coastline and fled in terror. Fact. So this is the entirely true story of the victory of exactly 50 Fishguard ladies. Fishguard ladies on a row, kiss them twice and wipe them up and look at them go. Blushing at the raindrops, curling up the cliff tops in the snow. 50 fishguard ladies in the line, boulders, breeze and monkeys with war in their minds. Staring at the sunset, waiting hushed and concrete for their time. Fishguard ladies all in frocks, hearts of hardy steel and heads like chimney pots. Crafty fingered wenches tying all the finches up. Thank you so much. thanks. So this next song is a tune that I wrote for a silent film that was shown at the BFI as part of the Silent Film Festival. And actually Foz Foster of David Devon and his Spirit Wife fame came and played in my orchestra. So I'd like to dedicate this to Foz, the spectacular Foz. Can we have a round of applause for his amazing guitar skills? And it was for a film called The Patsy, which I think is really as relevant today as when it was written in 1927. It stars Marion Davis, and it's kind of like a Cinderella story, but set in the jazz age. So in the shadow of her beautiful, very glamorous, traditionally beautiful older sister, Patsy is incredibly clever, ridiculously clumsy, frequently drunk, and always says exactly the wrong thing at precisely the right moment. And we end up totally falling in love with her through the course of the film. So in a world where we're bombarded with images of what it means to be beautiful, this is for clumsy, quirky, kooky, ugly, beautiful ducklings everywhere. And it's called Not the Kind of Girl.
She's not the kind of girl for you. Not the femme fatale who haunts your daydreams. Not the glamour puss that you've been craving always. She's not the kind of pearl for you. Not the debutante who holds her spoon right. Not the sort of eyes to turn the moonlight blue. For a girl should be gentle, full of grace and class and style, and not have so much mischief in her smile. She says is quite peculiar, and everything she does strange things to you. And everybody knows she's not the girl for you.
She's the kind of girl for you. She's that funny thing that sent you reeling. She's the little lack that you've been feeling always. She's the kind of pearl for you. She's that shining star of secret glory, and soon her fairy tale will be your story too. For who needs a princess or a goddess or a nun when you could have them all rolled into one? Every word she says is quite peculiar, and everything she does strange things to you. And everybody knows that she's the girl for you.
Thanks so much. We're going to do a few very new songs now from album number 7.
This is called Letters I Haven't Written, the album. And this is one that I have written. And I wrote it to an amazing talent. Some of you might know him, a brilliant, talented poet, comedian, Byron Vincent, a friend of mine, who is also a wonderful mental health activist and voice out in the world. But I wrote it when he was sectioned in a hospital. And I think mental health is, it's ridiculous that it still seems to have a stigma attached to it in this day and age. Some of the most brilliant, beautiful, warm-hearted, elastic-brained and magical people that I have in my life suffer from some kind of mental health issue, and I want us all to be able to talk about it. And I think when you're around that, sometimes it's hard to know what to do. So this is what I did. I wrote this letter to Byron, and really it's an offering of a hand in friendship to anybody who has ever suffered in that way. And it's called Frosting on My Windows.
I can't fix it.
Thank you so much. This next one is another letter song, this time to the man who probably had more creative influence on my life than anyone else, my sixth form music teacher, Martin Reed from Alton. He was a nest-haired, egg-shaking, suit-smashing, barefooted anarchist and a brilliant composer. He wrote a symphony for the mobile telephone and an aria for the piano stool and an opera about Basingstoke. And I think anyone that can find the poetry in Basingstoke is truly a genius. He made me hear the music and everything, and this is for him. It's called More of Everything. So the day when I got up, the bed creaked so melodically, so sweetly and so sonically, I lay back down and got up again. Lay back down and then got up again. And then the next 5 minutes going up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, a morning symphony. And then I had to write it down. And as I waited for the bus, there were two old ladies chattering, a tittle tattle nuttering, and did she know? No, she never did. Well, did she know? No, she never did. And so the next 10 minutes going, did no, never know, did no, never know, did I, did you, did she? And then I had to write it down. And then I had to write and tell you that. Well, you know that I hear more, more in every little thing. And every day is more, and every melody is new. And I reach for more, more in every little thing. More of everyone and everywhere. And more of me, because of so then I went to buy some peas. My trolley had a monkey with it, made a shuffle and a squeal, and I went up the aisle and then down again, and up the aisle and then down again. And then the next half hour going trolley polyphony. And then I had to write it down. And then I went to catch the train. The carriage did a pretty dance. A choir of Lincoln City fans all going oi la la, ticka ticka tacka, oi la la, ticka ticka tacka. And then the whole long journey going oi la, ticka tacka, oi ticka la, ticka transit symphony. And then I had to write it down. And then I had to write and tell you that. Well, you know that I hear more, more in every little thing. And every day is more, and every melody is new. And I reach for more, more in every little thing. More of everyone and everywhere. I'm more of me because of. So lay down your arms and throw off your shoes and dance like your legs have got nothing to lose. Keep it all on the edge, keep it all out of sight. Throw your map to the ground and just head for the light. And always carry an egg in your back pocket. Don't ever let the suits grind you down. No, I can't stand that overblown baloney man. Don't go playing no blues for no phony elites. Take it out of their pockets and onto the streets. Match it up past
and he had a yellow bag given to her by her sometime dad old Sam. It'll keep the ghosts away. Silver bangles and a pop balloon.
Shit.
Silver bangles and a pop balloon. Ruby lipstick and a postcard of the moon. She'll be leaving soon. Oh, Annie, where did you sleep last night? Oh, Annie, hold your head up high. Oh, Annie, won't you hold on tight to your yellow bag, yellow bag, yellow bag. Sets up very right, meets the cosmonauts by candlelight to conceive. The music helps her breathe. She's got a past to give, the boys a scare. She's got the future in her sights, which stares at her feet. They never feel the heat. Ghosts are saying, lie down, lie down. Little Annie had a yellow bag, tacky tickets from that gig at Vanity Loft. That's where the room took off. She's got a pass to give the boys a scare. She's got the future in her sight. Stares at her feet. They never feel the heat. Oh, Annie, where'd you sleep last night? Oh, Annie, hold your head up high. Oh, Annie, won't you hold on tight to your yellow bag, yellow bag, yellow bag. And all the ghosts are saying, la la, la la. And all the boys are saying, jump it, jump. And all the songs are saying giga, giga. And all the snips are saying racka, racka. And all the spooks are saying walk on, walk on. And all the junkies are saying turn on, turn on. And all the kids are saying hop up, hop up. And all the ghosts are saying lie down, lie down. Oh, Annie, where did you sleep last night? Oh, Annie, hold your head. Oh, Annie, won't you hold on tight to your yellow bag, yellow bag, yellow bag. Oh, Annie, where'd you sleep last night? Oh, Annie, hold your head up high. Oh, Annie, won't you hold on tight to your yellow bag, yellow bag, yellow bag.
Thank you. Can I invite Fuzz up to the stage with his magical sword? Fuzz, do you want to join us for tune? Huge round of applause for Fuzz.
Was not the first, She sung her song, she spun him a curse, cried for the loss of another. Her sea green eyes never miss a trip, those sweet mojitos pack quite a kick. Her careless smile cuts her to the quick, cried for the loss of another. Watch the dreams go by, drift as lost in the rain. Oh, Lorelei, Lady Lorelei, chalk it up, my one more deep for the street lamp flickers, she picks up the tab. She's got him flying with a sniff and a dab. All hips and bum, back on the cab. Cry out for the loss of another. You're a beautiful child, you've got the voice of an angel. Child, you've got the voice of a devil. Just take away our feathers and your chains. See how they're on. Oh, Lorelei, Lady Lorelei, watch the dreams go by. Chalk it up, my life. One more deal for the day. She took him well, and the taking was fast. She shook him up, shook him from my mast. It's not the first, not be the last. Cry out for the loss of another. The loss of another.
Now, I'm aware that we're running over, Rachel, because we started really late. How much longer have we got, just so that I can... I'm just thinking about the play afterwards. Is Rachel around? She's out there. Okay.
A couple more songs.
Perfect. Okay. Let's do Body Song and then My Mini Me. This song is a letter song, imagining my body as an evolving letter over time.
Scar now red with feeling.
you so much. You've been such an amazing audience. Can I hear it one more time for my lovely piano player, Ned Cartwright? Hear it one more time for all of the acts that have played today so far. Luke Wright, Attila the Hun, Solid the Stockbroker, and of course, the lovely David Devon. So Ned is not only my piano player, he's also my husband. And I'm very lucky about that. And we're also really excited because the woman registrar who married us is here tonight. And she's going to be doing a play in the next door room in approximately 10 minutes. So she's obviously somebody that helps people make really good life decisions. So I just recommend going and checking out her play. You've been amazing. This last song will involve all of you. It's like a kind of a road trip song, but imagine that instead of a Harley Davidson or a Thunderbird convertible or a pickup truck, all you have at your disposal is a really crap 1981 Mini Mayfair. And every time you go over a speed bump, the exhaust falls off. This is called My Mini and Me. I want to pack it all in, pack up and go to sea, and wind down like Huckleberry Finn, sleep in a poplar tree. Time I gave my mind a rest, want to feel some of that wordlessness, away from the smog and the noise and the maze. My mini and me, I want to give it all up, give it to the deep, hand my soul to Lady Luck before it goes to seed, and rattle along in the outside lane, a place where nobody knows my name, away from the smog and the noise and the shade. My mini and me, take me away. That's your bit. Come on and take me.
Take me away.
Come on and take.
Take me away.
I wanna break it all down, break into the deep. Gonna quit this grimy town, leave the rotten cheap. Ain't got no chauffeur, no saloon, nor much in the way of elbow room. But away from the smog and the noise and the glow, my mini and me,
take me.
Come on and take me away. Come on and take. Preach my name in reverent tones, and every passing day, walk to fall of praise. And everyone who was unkind, go scorn your golden canna smiles. Each second that I'm gone, think of how you did me wrong. Come on and take me. Come on and take me now, honey. Come on and take me now, baby. Come on and take me now. Come on and take me now, honey. Come on and take me away. enjoy the rest of your evening. Thank you.
Right, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen, Gwyneth Herbert!